Hello friends, in this video I am going to explain you Banker's algorithm with the help of example. In the given example, 5 processes are given, process P1, P2, P3, P4 and P5. The resource types R1, R2, R3, R4 are given. The contents of allocated resources is given in the allocation matrix. The maximum request of each process is given in the maximum request matrix, and available is given here with respect to all resource type. Now, in order to allocate the resources to all processes given in the problem, we need to check the safe state. If system finds a safe state, then resources are allocated. Now we'll see how to find the safe sequence. In order to find the safe sequence, we'll see it processes by processes given in the problem, like process P1, P2, P3, P4, P5, and check the condition as per given in the Banker's algorithm. Here we'll consider one variable as work equal to available, and the value 1520, which is given in the problem. Now, as discussed in the previous video, how to calculate the need matrix. From need matrix, we take the value of need for process P1, which is 000. And according to Banker's algorithm, we'll check the condition. If need of process P1 is less than or equal to work, if it is true, then we'll modify the value of work, and that process is considered in the safe sequence. So in order to modify the work value there, which is given in the Banker's algorithm, work equal to work plus allocation of P1. So value of work that is available, which is 1520, plus allocation of P1 is 0012, as given in the problem. So accordingly, work value get modified like 1530. Now we'll consider this same work value for checking the condition for process P2. So now for process P2, work is 1532. We'll take the need value of process P2, which is 0750, as we calculated in the previous video. We'll compare need of P2 with the current work. So here this condition fails. Like, suppose 0 is less than or equal to 1, okay, it is true for R1, but if we check for R2, 7 is not less than or equal to 5, so condition gets false, means we cannot allocate the resources for process P2, so process P2 has to wait. Now we'll skip process P2 and check for the process P3. We are considering same work value for process P3, because in P2 case work did not get modified. So work is same as 1532. Need of P3 is 1002. We compare need of process P3 with work. It is true. So value of work get modified, and process P3 is added in the safe sequence. Same way we check for process P4 with modified work value as 2886, and comparing need of P4 with the current work, it is again true, so we modify the value of work and P4 is added to the safe sequence list. In the same way, we'll check for process P5. So modified value of work was 2, 14, 11, 8. NID of P5U is 0642. We compare the NID of P5U with work. So this becomes true. So we modify the work value and which becomes 2 14 12 12. Now as we previously process P2 was in waiting state due to insufficient of resources, that's why we'll now check the value of work and we try to find the condition of need and work will satisfied for P2. We'll repeat the same procedure. Now we'll consider the work value as 2 14 12 12. Need of P2 was 0750. After comparing need of P2 with the current work, condition becomes true and we'll modify the value of work. It means now we can allocate the resource to process P2. In this way, we can find the safe sequence as P1, P3, P4, P5 and P2. In this sequence, we are allocating the resources to the process and which goes in the safe state. These are the references which I used. Thank you for watching this video.